You know, somebody said Macbeth is their favorite. So just take a minute to kind of retrieve what your favorite Shakespeare plays are, Shakespeare adaptations are, and we kind of start talking about it. Today, to conduct the session, we had Devin. So Devin, until a few months ago, was not really into Shakespeare, and now he's full of Shakespeare because, you know, he he kind of started reading a little bit about Shakespeare. We were talking about it. And like many of you, he had, you know, mainly encountered Shakespeare through films and the occasional play, because Devin is also into theatre, so he also does a little bit of that. Any of you here who actually been in a play, a Shakespearean play?
No, not Shakespeare, just a play.
You've just been in a play. But have you encountered, you know, or seen Shakespearean...
I've read Shakespeare.
Okay, tell us your name, ma'am.
Aradhana. I have just finished my BSc in mathematics.
Okay. Tell us a little bit about your theatrical
encounters. Yeah, so well, I've been learning German for a lot of years. So there was this German theatre competition. So that was in January. So me and my friends just decided on a whim to just take part. So that was my first time being on stage. I was one of the main. There were only two actresses. I was one of the main. And I had a lot of fun, actually. It was a very new and unusual, challenging experience for me. And it was a lot of fun.
Thank you. And just a request of everybody, because my phone has just started to ring and fortunately it was on silent. So if you could just put your phones on silent for the next 1 hour or so, it'll just make life a little easier. Yes, ma'am.
I'm Yashanta Roy. I have been teaching actually physics and maths, but I am very fond of plays and directing and writing a little bit. So I've always felt that children don't get an opportunity nowadays to get acquainted with Shakespeare. So during the course of my activities in school, I began to start off these short parts of Shakespeare and make the children enact about a half an hour bit. Out of which it was so popular, we were so surprised that the children were so interested. That 1 year we did something very interesting. We took Macbeth. We had four houses, you know, most of you have been in school and four houses you have and all that, you know, how nice it is. So we used to have this competition. So we took Macbeth, divided it into four parts and made the children compete so that the whole audience saw the whole play. Of course, the actors kept changing, but that was very good fun. Because we didn't need to change the backdrop. The backdrop remained the same. Only the actors kept changing and the whole play was visible. It was such a resounding success. We were astonished as teachers. The children took to it so well. So that has been my interesting experience with Shakespeare.
All right, so we've just warmed up and we have a lot of time ahead of us to hear everybody's experiences. So Devin is ready, so I'm going to hand it over to Devin, who will take us through the next 45 minutes or so. All right, Devin. I'll keep this.
Thank you, Ramanan. So, yeah, as he stated, I wasn't much into Shakespeare a month ago. But yeah, now I know some plays, I know some characters, and I'm going to ask, you know, I get a chance to be on this side of the mic and ask you questions and, you know, check if your knowledge is as good as mine. So just kidding. But yeah, it's not a very very hardcore, very... you know it or you don't know it kind of a session. There are lots of hints. The main point about this session is, as he stated, is to have fun, to have chocolates after giving right answers is the main point, and to of course learn along the way about Shakespeare, about the Bard of Avon. So let's get started, let's get into it and see how it pans out. So we go to the next slide. So yeah, we obviously call this quiz to quiz or not to quiz, which is obviously to be or not to be. I think everyone should know that in the house. So basically, Shakespeare, widely regarded as the greatest writer in the English language, is often called as England's national poet and the Bard of Avon, because he was born on Stratford-upon-Avon. He's authored 38 plays, 154 sonnets, two long narrative poems, and also a few other verses. I mean, yeah, everything is covered. Produced his most of his works during 1589 and 1630, and he died on 23rd April 1616, and as someone stated, it's the 400th anniversary. So let's move on to the next slide. And yeah, the content. So we have interesting, fun rounds. I mean, at least the titles of the rounds are fun. First is called Julius Quizzer. Second is What's in a Name, which is obviously, you know, what's in the name, and he wrote his name below that. Everyone knows that famous trope, right? Yeah, so that's second round. Third is As We Like It, not As You Like It. And last one is It's All Quiz to Me. So It's All Greek to Me was what he said famously. So very innovative words and phrases coined by Shakespeare. We'll learn about them along the way. So let's get started with the first round. But yeah, before we begin, a question for you. Have you read it? I think we've just done this. So now we'll skip this part. Yeah, let's go to Julius Quizzer. 10 questions from the world of Shakespeare. Alright, really simple ones. How this works is, we show a question, you guys raise your hand, and I come to you, and if you answer correctly, you get a chocolate, alright? And plus the respect of the room, which is more important than the chocolate. Also, I'm going to be a fair host, if not lovely. I'm going to give everyone a fair chance, so, let's see how many different people I can cover, alright? So let's get started with the first question of the quiz. It is believed that this famous person played the ghost of Hamlet's father and also Adam in As You Like It. He's also acted in Every Man in His Humour and Sejanus His Fall. However, his exclusion from Ben Jonson's Volpone is generally thought to be the point where his acting career started nearing its end. So who is this famous person that we're talking about? Which actor are we talking about? Raise your hands. Also, don't feel shy. There are no negative markings, or don't worry about people looking at you. Hey, is it supposed to be a guess? Don't worry about those kind of things. Be free. Take a guess. What's on the top of your mind? And you might win a chocolate for yourself. Yeah.
Is it Laurence Olivier?
No, it's not Laurence Olivier. Okay. No, I see the first question. Everyone's stumped. Okay, do you want me to give a hint?
Yes.
But let me tell you, everyone in this house, everyone who is here knows the answer. So just raise your hand if you want to take a guess. Alright, one hand right there. And what's your name?
Nupur,
what's the guess?
Shakespeare.
Yeah, the quiz is about Shakespeare. The first question has to be about William Shakespeare himself. So brilliant answer by Nupur. That was a googly from all sides. So the bard himself, not so famous an actor, but yeah, every director has sometime, in his career has acted. Like Rajkumar Hirani was a famous Fevicol ad, if you remember. Yeah. So every director has, or every writer has sometime in his career has acted. So this is the bard himself. So a chocolate for Nupur. Moving on. Andrei Tchaikovsky, not the famous Russian Tchaikovsky, this is a Polish composer. He died at the age of 46. In his will, he left a part of his body to the Royal Shakespeare Company. Thus, what role does he posthumously play in some shows of Hamlet? Right? So, I see a hand back there. Yeah. So, what's your name first? Dipti. And have you seen Hamlet, or have you read about?
I've seen the BBC production.
What's your guess?
Was it the skull?
Let's go to the answer slide. And you can see it is absolutely correct. This is the skull of Yorick. So, you've seen Haider, right? You've seen where Shahid Kapoor is talking to the skull. This is essentially that scene replicated. So, this is the skull of Yorick. And this is actually Dave Tennant holding Andrei Tchaikovsky's skull. It was not used until sometime, but in this production, it was 2008 London production. Dave Tennant said, I'm going to use this, and this is the famous photograph of him holding Andrei Tchaikovsky. So good answer there, Dipti. A chocolate for you, and a wonderful answer there. Moving to the third one. So this is something, you can work this out. You don't need to have read about or watched Macbeth. When Macbeth visits the three witches, they inform him that no man born of a woman shall harm him. But still, Macduff is able to kill Macbeth in the final act. How?
So I saw her hand go up first, so just go to take her guess first.
My name is Gargi.
Gargi, yeah. Alright.
He is born not naturally. He had to scissor.
We'll give it to her. That's a perfect explanation. Let's put our hands together for her. That's a wonderfully worked out answer. So he was not born naturally. He was born by a cesarean section. So the line goes that in the final act, Macbeth says to Macduff that, hey, you can't kill me. I was told by the witches that no man born of a woman shall harm me. But Macduff says, hey, I am born of a woman, but untimely ripped is the line that's used. So hence he got killed. So yeah, overconfidence did Macbeth there. So yeah. Yeah, people sitting at the back in the balcony can come ahead in the front.
Take the chairs and come ahead.
Yeah.
So you can see at the table and
then. So we'll move on to the.
Short of chairs. Then get these chairs up front. Yeah, just come up front. Sit three at the table, just some of you.
This some space over here. So we have to sit down, then we can also.
Come up. Ma'am, can you come up here?
Okay. Alright, yeah, I'll read most of it out, so shouldn't be worried. So let's move on. Okay, this is a picture on the left. This is Lago di Torre, Argentina. It's a square in Rome, Italy. It has now become a no-kill shelter for homeless cats. But it hosts four Republican Roman temples, and you know, this is the remains of the Pompey's theater. But this secluded place, this, you know, kind of Pompey's theater in a mess, was infamous for an event that occurred here, which took place in the Curia on the Ides of March. So yeah, sir, there. He's already raising his hand. What's your name first?
My name is Praveen.
Praveen, and what infamous event are we talking about?
This is Caesar's assassination.
Caesar's assassination. Let's hear it for him. Perfect answer. Assassination of Julius Caesar is absolutely correct. So basically he was going, the story goes that he was going to the Senate, and on the steps he was stabbed. The last one to stab was Brutus, so hence the famous words. Alright, it features in the question somewhere in the future, so you can take a guess then. Alright, moving on. Oh, this is one interesting question. These images show Shakespeare's coat of arms. So the one on the right appeared on a rough draft of an application that was granted to John Shakespeare, his father. And the left is a modernized version of the same. Now, why was this particular weapon chosen? So, you know, you have to look carefully at the coat of arms and you have to tell me why was this particular weapon chosen. And if you know how coat of arms usually were designed back in the day, you can arrive at the answer. So take a guess. You know, it's really workable. You know, take a calculated guess. There's one hand raised again. I'll see if someone else is raising. So yeah, there's one hand here. Since I just took your answer, yeah. What's your name?
Sarvika.
Sarvika, and what's your guess?
It looks like an arrow to me.
So why arrow? Why would they choose an arrow and not a hammer or something?
Probably because he is a hunter or something.
Oh, okay. No, not that. I mean, probably.
I don't know.
He wasn't a hunter, definitely. So no arrow and other guess?
His father's business.
His father's business. Good guess, but not correct. Not his father's business. So yeah, I'll take your guess now, sir.
Cupid's arrow.
So Cupid's arrow. No. So anyone else? Why would they choose? So look at the weapon carefully. It's a very simple weapon to recognize, first of all. And then just relate the weapon's name to Shakespeare. Simple one.
Spear, right?
All right, now all the Sherlocks in the house. So let's have a round of applause for all of you. Sudden epiphany. Yes. So obviously, let's go to the answer side. So Spear, it's a pun on the family name. That is why. Usually the coat of arms are chosen, you know, something quirky, something tricky. So they chose the spear because obviously a pun on the family name. So good answer, a collective effort there. So no chocolates or all chocolates. Something like that. Okay. Okay, so these are some of the plots of Shakespeare plays described in one line. Very concise, probably very bad, but you know, very funny. So to
it's a Twitter friendly
round, this question. So you have to name them all, alright? So how what we do is, I'll show you the first one and let's see who can get it wrong first, okay? So let's just check the first one. Two couples, so raise your hand. No, let's not shout the answer out. So I'll take his guess. Two couples get lost on a summer's day.
Midsummer's night dream
is absolutely correct, but let's see how far he can go. Alright, let's see where you get it wrong. So next one, a beautiful queen is bitten by a snake. Alright, your name, sir?
Rahul,
you get the first one. Any guesses for the second one? Very famous incident, a beautiful queen is bitten by a snake. I'll have to pass you and go to, what's your name?
I'm Raj Nerkar.
Alright, and what's your guess?
Antony and Cleopatra.
Is absolutely correct. So one all here is the score. Let's see if you can get the next one right. Next one. A hunchback slaughters all who block his way. Also, before anyone gives a guess to this, there's a reason why this has been put at the position that it is put in. Okay, that's a clue for you.
I can't guess.
No guess? So the score is 1-1. Any other hands raised? All right. What's your guess?
Merchant of Venice.
Not the Merchant of Venice. At the back. Richard III. I've put this in place 3 because it's Richard III. Brilliantly worked out. So now let's see if you can get the next one right. It's like a chain here, chain reaction. So fourth one, if you can see, it's written Forest of Arden sets the scene for this romance.
I'll take a guess.
Not the Tempest. Hello, lady near you.
Hello.
Can't hear you.
Hello.
I just take her guess, yeah. As You Like It is absolutely correct. So we have all 4 answers in between them, but no one got 2. You get a 5th one. Yeah, you get a 5th chance. An English king decides to conquer France. Again, I'll give you the same end. As I have put the 3rd one in 3rd place, this I have put for the same reason in the 5th place. Is absolutely correct. So she gets a couple, hence she gets the chocolate. But a round of applause to all of you who decoded perfectly. Yeah, let's give everyone a chocolate. So, As You Like It. Yeah. So, A Midsummer Night's Dream, Antony Cleopatra, Richard III, As You Like It, and Henry V. Again, the reason for Henry V and Richard III, the position was indicative of their titles. Yeah, moving on. She's the Man is a 2006 romantic comedy film. That's the poster. The film centers on teenager Viola Hastings, who enters her brother's school in his place, pretending to be a male. Very, very entertaining movie. So she plays with the boys in the soccer team. What's the inspiration behind this movie?
Yeah.
I just saw her hand go up, so I'll just take a guess. What's your name?
My name is Satakshi.
Satakshi, and what's your guess?
Is it As You Like It?
No.
Not As You Like It. I'll just read out what that reads. Everybody has a secret. Duke wants Olivia, who likes Sebastian, who really is Viola. So just a clue for you guys. Viola, Sebastian, Olivia are the characters from the original play. So, all right. Don't call me sir. What Sharif? Sorry, that's a dialogue problem. All right. What's your name?
Manasa.
Manasa. What does that mean?
It means mine.
Mine, alright. Let's see if you can apply it. And what's the answer?
It's the 12th night.
It is the 12th night. A round of applause for her. Wonderful. So Manasa gets this right.
12th Night or What You Will is the complete title. So wonderful answer. So the poster is very indicative. So she basically disguises herself and plays in this boys' soccer team. This is a very interesting question. So I'll just read it out for you guys first. So pictured is Henry Wriothesley, the 3rd Earl of Southampton. He is believed to be that unknown fair youth who is mentioned multiple times alongside the dark lady and the rival poet. So these three are the prominent characters, alright? The fair youth, the dark lady and the rival poet. Other contenders for fair youth include William Herbert, William Hall, William Harvey, etc. So you can see there initials are generally WH or HW, alright? So people have speculated who could these men be. Where would one come across these characters? Alright, couple of tentative hands raised here. Nupur, I've already taken your guess, I've also taken your guess, so I'll just go back there. Yeah, what's your name? Alright, and what's your guess? These are from the sonnets. Let's go to the answer slide, and I think that is one of the most wonderful answers of the night. So let's hear it for her. These are from the sonnets. So yeah, obviously the famous one is Shall I Compare Thee to a Summer's Day. Yeah. Also 154 sonnets were written. Out of that, I think 126 were addressed to this fair youth. I don't know what Shakespeare was thinking, but yeah. Okay. Pretentious play plots. So these are plays of Shakespeare described in three panels basically. You have to identify the plays, alright? We go the same way again till you get it wrong. So let's see the first one. I just read it out. Shylock claims a pound of flesh from Antonio. Portia, okay, already deciphered. Okay, I'll come to this table. What's your name, ma'am?
I'm Leenu.
And the
Merchant of Venice.
The Merchant of Venice, yes, a pound of flesh is obviously a Merchant of Venice. Let's see if you can get this one too. Cousins Arcite and Palamon both love Emilia. Arcite and Palamon fight a duel over Emilia. Arcite falls off a horse and dies. Palamon gets Emilia. So, no hands raised. A tentative hand raised, yeah.
As you like it.
Not as you like it. As you like it seems to be the favorite incorrect guess, but yeah, not as you like it. It's one of the Oh, one hand raised there, so let's see. Solitary hand. Sorry? Not Othello. I'll just give you a hint. This is not one of the very well known plays. It's one of the not so well known plays. Also, one hint is cousins. So, cousins, Arcite and Palamon. So cousins is a very important word. They are related to each other. And they are two people. So what could be the title? Simple.
Two gentlemen of
Verona is absolutely the wrong guess. Next one. Yeah.
Taming of the Shrew?
Not Taming of the Shrew. Yeah. What's your name?
Shivraj,
you get it right. Two noble kinsmen it is. So because they are related, they are cousins, so it's two noble kinsmen. So, wonderfully worked out. Did you work it out or you knew it? You just added up 2 plus 2, wonderful. That's how you answer a quiz question. From heaven to hell is flown away. I hate, from hate away she threw. And saved my life saying, not you. This is the ending of Shakespeare's sonnet number 145. The marked words are allegedly a pun on the name of someone very close to the bard. So you have to explain. The usual suspects have already have their answers. But I'll go to someone new. Yeah.
My name is Anindita.
All right.
The answer is Anne Hathaway.
The actress.
No,
the wife. Is absolutely correct. So Anne, can we go back to the? Yeah, so Shakespeare, so people, TIL moment for you, yeah, Shakespeare was married to Anna, the different Anna. So can we go back to the question once? Yeah, so Shakespeare was very, you know, intelligent in his framing. From heaven to hell is flown away, I hate from hate away. So hate away is a pun on Hathaway, and she threw, and saved my life is actually, and saved my life. So
You know? Yeah. Shakespeare was a damn run of his time. So moving on. So okay, just a couple of questions for you. What was the first Shakespeare play or poem that you came across? Anyone wants to share their experience? Yeah.
So I was in the second grade when I started reading abridged versions of Shakespeare. So As You Like It was the first one I read, and then after that I read Romeo and Juliet, Merchant of Venice, and Hamlet, and
so you've read it like end to end.
I started with abridged. And then
as
I grew up, then I read the original plays, then I read Tales of Shakespeare.
So you like the condensed version or the original version?
It depends on which play it is.
Oh, okay, correct. Agreed, yes. So yeah, good point, and you know, the good point that you can actually have the condensed version read as well. So people who don't want to read, I mean, who are not, you know, really into reading, and those who want to start with Shakespeare, you can start with those abridged versions.
Does this Tales of Shakespeare,
Charles
and Mary
Ann.
Yes.
Right. So, yeah. That's the book for you. So let's. All right. One more.
First one I read was The Tempest, which was from Charles and Mary Ann. In fact, then I read the entire book. But since you asked,
just. Nice. All right. So again, Tempest was your favorite. Let's just have one more.
After 7th or 8th, Shakespeare was introduced to us in school. So each year, like we started with Romeo and Juliet, we started with Macbeth, and not only we had it as a part of our literature and language classes, our school theatrics and cultural programs, we were made to enact those plays. Not only of Shakespeare, many others, but this is how I was introduced to this.
And your name?
I'm Jayashree Bakshi.
Jayashree, wonderful. I think that's a brilliant experience. And I think the point to take away from this is, I mean, reading is fine, but enacting it out, I think you can kind of relate it more when you enact it out rather than read it.
One of your favorites was Julius Caesar.
Wonderful. So yeah, thank you for sharing your experiences. We'll move on with the next round. Yeah. What's in a name? So five questions on entities that are named after Shakespeare characters or quotes. All right. So let's see what the first question is. Morbid jealousy is a psychological disorder in which a person constantly thinks that their spouse or partner is being unfaithful towards them without having much proof. This is dubbed as the Dash syndrome after the central character of a Shakespeare play. So morbid jealousy, I have not seen your answer, so what's your name?
Is it Macbeth?
No. What's your name? Yuvraj is not Lady Macbeth, so any new idea? Othello, what's your name? Sani Kaza. How does Othello relate to morbid jealousy? Yeah, perfect answer there. Othello is the right answer. So basically, you can see Iago was the, you know, mastermind. He you know, planted the seeds of doubt in Othello's mind, and he killed Desdemona, his wife, and then he killed himself. So yeah, I think morbid jealousy fits Othello. So perfect name there for the syndrome, Othello syndrome. Let's move on. Simple one. A balconet is an architectural term to describe a false balcony. As you can see, when the window is open, it gives the appearance of a balcony. A prominent example is on the Palazzo Labbia in Venice. What are these types of balconies commonly referred to as? So, you.
I don't know what they're called, but I know in which play they are. Yeah.
So what would they be called? Add it.
Juliet.
Simple, you are there. Balcony. Juliet's balcony is absolutely correct. So they are obviously famous. You've seen this scene from Romeo and Juliet a number of times. So yeah, they are named after Juliet. They're called Juliet Valkyries. That's absolutely correct. Your name?
Shreya.
Shreya. Perfect answer there. So, yeah. Desdemona, Juliet, Map, Portia, Rosalind, Margaret, etc., etc. Out of a total 27, 24 of them have been named after Shakespearean characters. The rest, 3, are named after the characters from the work of Alexander Pope. What are we talking about?
So,
as in we need to name the characters.
No, so see, I have named some characters about them. Essentially all the female characters from Shakespearean plays. They, basically their names are given to something, alright? 24 of them. And the rest 3 come from the works of Alexander Pope. So what set of 27 am I talking about? What 27 can you imagine? I'll give you a hint, but if someone cracks this at this moment, I don't know. You can give it 2 chocolates.
Yeah.
Drinks.
Sorry?
Drinks.
Not drinks. What
satellites.
Comes what?
Satellites.
Closer, very closer. Very closer. Far away. Satellites, moons, yes. Closer.
I would
like, my guess. Moons is like in the ballpark, right there. Moons of?
Jupiter. Or Saturn.
There are a few number of planets.
Yeah. People. So Jupiter is out, Saturn is out, Venus is out.
Uranus
is absolutely correct. So these are moons of Uranus, named after Shakespearean characters. So round of applause for you. Perfect answer. So there are 27 moons of Uranus. They are named after these literary characters. So next question is quote unquote. So you have to identify the original dialogues on which the below works are based on. So basically there are some works, some posters I'll show you. What original dialogue are they based upon? First one, the Three Stooges, all the world's a stooge. So yeah. Yeah. Can you give me a complete version?
No, it's fine.
I mean, your name?
All the world's a stage and we are actors. All players are all something. I don't know.
I'll give it to you. What's your name?
Rajesh.
Rajesh. Perfect answer there. So all the world's a stage from? Now comes the very common answer. As you like it. Alright. Next one is The Fault in Our Stars. This is a book by John Green. So The Fault in Our Stars, I have come to you and I have come to you, I also come to you. So new faces, new hands. I always give a chance to you. Yeah, so okay. So Fault in Our Stars, what's the original quote?
The fault of Brutus is not in our stars but in ourselves. It is from Julius Caesar.
Couldn't have put it better myself. Perfect answer. The fault in our stars, dear Brutus, is not in our stars but in ourselves that we are underling. So. I mean, how did you remember the exact quote? I mean, anyway.
Probably one of my favorite quotes.
All right. Wonderful, wonderful answer. Okay, this is an interesting one. In one experiment, people were asked to recall a good or bad past deed, after which they were asked to fill in the letters of these incomplete words. Those who recalled a bad deed were about 60% more likely to respond with cleansing-related words. All right. So, like, suppose if you have done a bad deed, you would fill this up with wash, shower, soap, rather than wish, shaker, stop, etc. This effect in which after doing a shameful act, one thinks about cleansing a lot, is known as dash dash effect. Because this character imagined blood stains on hands after committing a murder. So already have some hands raised, yes. You. Sorry? There are 2 blanks there, so I'll...
Lady Macbeth.
Lady Macbeth is absolutely correct. So it comes when she imagines the blood stains on the
Minus 4, sir.
Alright.
-4
Merchant
of Venice.
Alright. For the reason?
She's a very strong woman who can actually bail out a poor man. But I like the quote, I like the thing that mercy, the quality of mercy is not strained, it falls, you drop it from the heavens above. That's my favorite quote.
Nice, wonderful. Yeah, one last, yeah. Pro Shylock, okay. Pro Shylock, yeah.
Not a dog. I think that's the
one. Yeah, something on those lines.
And also discrimination. Yeah, that's also there.
Yeah, but Shylock is your favorite. Good, yeah. So good answers there, good insights. Okay, one more, yeah.
What answer again?
Yeah,
let me your ears.
So you can see that Shakespeare applies to all walks of life, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, so wonderful insights there and some good new quotes to learn for me. So As We Like It is around based on Shakespeare references, adaptations, inspirations in Indian cinema. So favorite of all, I think. So yeah, Bollywood connects basically. So first one, these images are from Gulzar's Angoor. So basically the film is about two pairs of identical twins. What original play? Yeah, you have not answered, I think. So
The Comedy of Errors
is absolutely correct. Your name? Yashoda. Yashoda.
Ah,
that's a whoa. That's a matter. Yeah, I think all the words are stated. Okay. So, my answer Yashoda, in Yashoda. Alright. Okay, so this is a scene from Farhan Akhtar's Dil Chahta Hai, which opera, based on a Shakespeare play, are the characters of Amir Khan and Preeti Zinta watching. So, just click on the arrow, yeah.
Even if I know
words,
so you can just...
Oh yeah, I think then...
If you've seen the movie, so you can...
Yeah, anyone who's seen the movie. Alright, so I'll not come to you. Yeah.
Troilus and Cressida.
Troilus and Cressida is absolutely correct. So this is perfect answer. Yeah. So prize for you. Yeah. So I'm moving on. Simple one. I think all the three original plays. I think I've not come to you. Take a guess, they are very simple. So original plays, yeah. Yeah. First one, so first one is?
Hamlet.
Second one is?
Macbeth.
Is correct. Third one is?
Othello.
Is correct, yeah. So Vishal Bharadwaj is. Also all the, if you notice all the movie name starting letters plus the character starting letters are also the same. So Langda Tyagi is Lago, you know, something on those lines. Othello is Omkar. Even the title of character names are same. So let's go to the next one. Let's check if the video is working. I think since we've switched it,
it might not work. So you can describe the scene.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, this is a video. What device from Hamlet is utilized in this clip? Okay. This is a video from Kurz, if you've seen that movie, Rishi Kapoor's movie. So what they do is, what Rishi Kapoor does is he's singing that Ek Haseena Thi song. If you remember that, it's the clip from that song. So in that song, he's on the stage and they are recreating something on a screen. All right. And he's seeing the lead actress's reactions. This is an adaptation from Hamlet, where Hamlet uses this to recreate the events to check Claudius's reaction. What is the particular name of this device? You know, what is the particular name of this? Yes, you have not answered.
The mousetrap.
The mousetrap is exactly what I was looking for. The mousetrap device, play within a play. So in the original play, it's also called Murder of Gonzago, but what generally happens is, he's checking, Hamlet is checking whether Claudius has done it or not, whether he's murdered his father or not. So he recreates those events in the play where, you know, someone pours poison into the ears of his father. So, and you know, Claudius basically gets out. So that's how he knows that he has murdered him. Similar thing in Haider, if you've seen the Bismil song is similar to Mousetrap play. So perfect answer there. So again, this is basically a video promotional video of Nana Patekar's Nata Samrat. So on which, yeah, you've not answered till now. So which original play is this based on? King Lear is absolutely correct. So good answer.
So again here, as he has those three daughters, who kind of, one daughter takes a side, but the rest of other two are not really kind. So similar thing in Natasamra. Alright. Okay, any other movie or TV series reference that you can think of for Shakespeare? I mean, some other, any other adaptation, yeah.
I don't know if it's an adaptation.
Can you pass on the mic, please?
I watched the movie Shakespeare in Love. I think you all should watch it. You'll have an idea about the writing of Romeo and Juliet. Just in, it's not actually happened. It's not that it happened, but it's just a idea that maybe it happened with him. So that's a movie you all should watch.
A
movie made on that?
Yeah.
Al Pacino.
Oh, yeah. It's fantastic.
Must watch this.
Midsummer's Night came also,
it's
been made into a movie.
Alright, so probably almost then all the mainstream plays have been, yeah. Correct. Any quirky reference, like, I mean, Curse is not based on Hamlet, but it has a sly reference to Hamlet. So any such quirky adaptation or, sequences? Yeah.
There's one movie, it's called Letters to Juliet. It's
not based on Romeo and Juliet, but no. Some references to Juliet's character.
It's like they go to Verona and everything.
Oh. Wonderful. I think that's one to watch. Yes. Nice suggestion there. So yeah, one more.
There was a movie by in which Amitabh Bachchan acted, and that was the last play.
The last play.
Was it based on yes, King? Yes. Oh,
yes.
Related. Okay, related to King. Yes.
He actually Amitabh Bachchan. He remembers Shakespeare, the journalist I think who goes to interview him, and then Amitabh Bachchan recites what he had learned. I think that's what.
That's the gist of it. Okay. Correct. Okay. Let's move on. So it's a quiz to me is the last round. So five questions on Shakespeare in popular culture and advertisement. So let's see what this round has. So what has been blanked out here? So raise your hand if you decipher it. Yeah. Okay. So see, there are some characters and someone is. Yeah, I think she got it. So let's check what her guess is. There is something I've blanked out. So what has been blanked?
Brutus.
Is absolutely correct. Yeah. Et tu, Brutus. Basically, Brutus.
Et tu, Brutus.
Et tu, Brutus. Yeah.
And it's
all
these Bluto.
So yeah. So Bluto, Brute. So nice answer there. So next one. Penguin Books created this brilliant ad campaign, which won a Gold Press Lion at Cannes Film Festival of Creativity. What were they advertising? So you can see the image. The image is like indicative. What were they advertising? Look at the image carefully and you will arrive at the answer. They won an award for this, so it has to be one of the most brilliant ads. So, alright, I have one hand raised here. What's your name?
Pragya, I'll just take a guess.
Yeah.
Is it audiobooks?
My audiobooks?
Because there's Shakespeare on one side and it looks like a headphone.
I think people are gasping here and that must be the correct answer. Wonderful answer there. I think brilliantly worked out. If you want to go back to the image, see it's shaped in the form of a headphone. So audiobooks, perfect answer. Really nicely worked out. So which famous sequence is being parodied in the Simpsons episode? Simpsons parody a lot. So you can see four panels there. A very famous sequence. If you can name the characters who are involved in the sequence, that'd be great. I'll just check with someone else before I come to you. Yeah. Not Macbeth and Duncan. Alright, yeah.
This is from Hamlet. Oops. This is from Hamlet, where Hamlet sort of pokes the sword into the behind the curtain.
And who's behind the curtain?
Polonius.
Perfect answer. Polonius getting killed by Hamlet. So he's talking to his mother and he doesn't know that someone is behind, but she gets frightened, and then Polonius comes out. He thinks he's Claudius, so he stabs him, but then he realizes that he's not Claudius. Similar thing again in Haider, you've seen. So if, I mean, you know, just to, if you want to relate it to that. So very famous sequence. This is again a video, I think it, we have to skip the video, so I'll just describe what's happening. So, yeah, so this is a Levi's 501 ad. The dialogues between Titania and Nick Bottom are taken from which original play? So, the gist of the ad is basically this, this guy who's walking down the street, he's the protagonist of this ad, and these people are, you know, kind of mocking him that, hey, you have an ass's head, is what the quote is. He says, so what, I'm just going to be here and sing, and Titania comes from there and says, I love thee. This is the gist of the ad. So, yeah, Titania, Nick Bottom, yeah. Ass's head, what original play?
Yes.
Yeah.
So much night dream.
Is absolutely correct. So, and what sequence is this?
I am not sure, but I know this. The names are...
Yeah, the names, the characters are familiar. Anyone knows the sequence that they have taken this?
Sequence,
as in... What was happening in the play? I mean, what part?
Bottom was actually a carpenter who had been changed into, had got the head of a bottom of an ass because he was bragging, and Puck, that is Robin Goodfellow, saw him put that juice of that flower into his ear, into his eyes, and then by mistake he did it in a Titania, so Titania would fall in love with whoever she first saw. It happened to be Bottom.
Yeah. Exactly, that is perfect. So basically he got an ass's head.
Say it's Midsummer Night's Dream, it's not Midsummer's Night Dream.
Yeah, it's Midsummer Night's Dream. So, yeah, as you can see in the picture, so in Nick Bottom, he's doing a play, he's an actor. So, as she mentioned, he's a carpenter. So basically, the Puck puts the potion in his eye and gives him ass's head. And Titania is given blessing or a curse that she would fall in love with anyone who's she sees first, and then she falls in love with him. So yeah, very funny. But Levi's turned it around, you know, to say, hey, even what if I have an ass and I'm still like him. So the last question, I think. So yeah. So this is a parody of the infinite monkey theorem. So from the Family Guy. So we did Simpsons. So similarly, Family Guy also had a parody. Explain what the infinite monkey theorem is and complete the quote. You know, tell me what the infinite monkey theorem is, because the quote, we can't really play it. So, take a guess, what could be the infinite monkey theorem? They also, you know, did some experiments to prove it, and it didn't work out that well. So, no. So, you can see in the image, the thumbnail image basically, that there are a lot of monkeys doing something. So it's based on that. Monkeys copying each other. No. So I'll give you a hint. All right. No. So don't go for the quote. Just tell me what the infinite monkey theorem is. Basically, you can see that particular monkey. He's doing something. Typing something. So, what could be the infinite monkey theorem? It's actually a theorem, yes. Yeah. Writing gibberish and turning out. I'll give it to you. That's absolutely correct. So, if you keep monkeys in a... Yes, the monkey and typewriter theorem. So, so basically the theorem is, if you put... given an infinite length of time, a chimpanzee punching random on a typewriter would almost surely, you know, type out all the Shakespeare plays. This is the theorem they proposed. They did an experiment. They put chimpanzee in a room, and all he typed was the letter S for a long time, is what their results were. But again, this states that it should be for an infinite length of time, so can't really test that. Obviously, the quote is, what's in a name, that which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet, was the quote in the clip, so we'll skip that part. So moving on. So yeah, the question and answer session is done. Let's perform some Shakespeare. So again, this also has some question element to it. So let's check what the first famous dialogue is. So I want someone to come ahead, recite this dialogue, tell me from what play is this. So a couple of things to do. For a chocolate, obviously.
This is from Henry the Fifth, isn't it?
This is from?
Henry the
Fifth? No. Alright? Yeah. Go for it. Okay.
This is from Julius Caesar.
Okay.
It's Mark Antony when he is giving the eulogy for Caesar.
Not quite.
When he gets that 5 minutes to say something about Caesar and then he turns it into an opportunity to
incite the
crowd.
I'm pretty sure that's not the one, but could be, but I'm sure this one is not from
this
one.
No.
Okay.
This is a different one, yeah.
I think it's Macbeth.
Not Macbeth. Oh, one of the funnier plots. Funnier, please.
12th?
Yeah, go for it.
12th
night? It is from 12th night. So we are very surprising, but it is from 12th night. Even I was shocked. I always thought it was from Julius Caesar, but it's from Twelfth Night. Let's see if you can say.
Is this about that poor chap who was living with him? They were
paddling
him.
No, I can't really remember the character's name, but it features in that play definitely.
Answer from here, okay?
Yeah.
Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them.
Let's hear it for a perfect. So. Let's go to the next famous dialogue. So simple one. Okay, I'll come to you at the back. Tell which play and recite the dialogue and get yourself a chocolate.
Merchant of Venice.
And the dialogue, recite
it. If you prick us, do we not bleed? If you tickle us, do we not laugh? If you poison us, do we not die? And if you wrong us, shall we not revenge?
Perfect. Here's a chocolate for that. And anyone who is looking for auditions or actors, there's your one candidate. All right. So last one. Yeah.
This is Julius Caesar.
Now this is Julius Caesar is absolutely correct. I won't say no. I'll decide for the chocolate.
Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant never taste of death but once.
Thank you.
Can I get a coaster instead?
You want a coaster, all right? So, that was the round. One last question for you guys. Any recommendations of some good books we've already heard from her? Any movies, videos or article to get an insight about Shakespeare's work?
Yeah.
All right, yeah.
There is a very good book by Bill Bryson. It's called Shakespeare. Bill Bryson is actually a travel writer and he's very, very humorous. But when he writes about Shakespeare, you find information about Shakespeare that normally you wouldn't even know existed, including the fact that the likeness of Shakespeare that you've put up here is not really a portrait of him from his lifetime. I didn't know that till I read Bill Bryson. And there are only two of those.
So Bill Bryson is one. Also, if you've seen QI, which Stephen Fry hosts, the QI series, quizzing kind of questions, they have an episode on Shakespeare. It's a wonderful episode. You get such insights from there too. It's also contested that, if he has even written all those works, was he some kind of a servant? It's all, all those theories are discussed there. But, you get to learn something really interesting. So, yeah, Bill Bryson is one. QI is one. Anyone else? Yeah, one more.
Yeah, and just to mention, British Council is the one who's celebrating the 400 years. And we have some marvelous adaptations, 2 minutes modern adaptation of Romeo and Juliet and all the other plays. We also have a QR which you can scan and the book will immediately download on your phone if you have the QR app. And we also have something really good which is called as Mix the Play. So in Mix the Play, you take one scene from Midsummer Night's Dream and you change the location, you change the actors and you become a director yourself and you can change the entire thing, the background music. And and make your own mix the play. So I would really actively encourage all of you all to just try these things out. And of course in the library we have the entire set of DVDs, books, etc. Okay? Please try out the mix the plays.
It's a very novel and, you know, interesting thing, you know, everyone should check that out. So yeah, so one last thing, any place performed in and around Pune, like any production houses or, you know,
about a decade ago, there was some company which did A Midsummer Night's Dream. In Pune at Nehru Auditorium, it was some amateur group and it was a decade ago. But I remember it.
Okay. Any current, anyone who's seen an ad or something in the paper or read about it that a Shakespeare play is happening? Alright, if no, then you know we should start something soon, very soon. Alright, so yeah, moving on. So this was the Spark session. I hope all you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed it a lot. Thank you for being such a wonderful audience. And I got to learn a lot from you guys. And enjoy your chocolates and hand it over to
yeah, and just before you guys go, tomorrow we'll be doing a similar session, but this time the topic will be Roald Dahl. Alright, so it's at 3 p.m. tomorrow. Same place, okay? So hope to see some of you there. Alright, thank you so much.